Hello and welcome to the learning series on the hardware and software used in power electronics. As the name suggests, here we will learn the hardware and software details of designing a power electronic converter. We will do this through our project on universal power converter. Yes, universal power converter means that it can be configured so as to achieve the functionality of any other converter. So namely, we will achieve four functionalities. First, DC to DC converter, then DC to AC, and then AC to DC. And finally, in AC to AC mode, we have two modes here. One is AC to AC voltage controller mode and AC to AC cycloconverter mode. So we will achieve these five functionalities and study the hardware and software of power electronics. So let's start. Okay, so let us first understand the circuit diagram of the universal power converter. As you see, we have used here IGBTs, that is insulated gate bipolar transistors, right? So each IGBT has a body diode, right? So we have used IGBTs in anti-parallel in each leg. So in each leg there are four IGBTs, and in the other there are four other. So this is port 1 and this is port 2. The magic of this converter is that this port 1 can be used either as an input or as an output, and this port can also behave vice versa, right? So if we give input here, we can take out the output here. If we give input here, then we can get the output here. So that is all from the circuit diagram of universal power converter. Okay, so let's see the hardware of the universal power converter. As you see here, this is the entire hardware circuit of the universal power converter. This is the auto transformer we are using to get a variable AC so that we can use to create either small DC outputs or any other type of AC waveform, right? And this is the DSO. And this is the load which we are using. This is a simple incandescent bulb which you can find in nearby shops. So let's see each and every floor of it. Well, the ground floor of the converter consists of the driver boards, which consists of the TLP250 board, and the rectifier boards, which is powered by the transformers. The second floor consists of the Arduino microcontroller, the Z series circuit, some inductors, and a rectifier circuit which we use to rectify the AC to DC so as to get a DC voltage for the UPC. And the final floor is consisting of IGBT power board. So each and every power board consists of power IGBTs. The gate supply is connected to a LED so that we can have a visual representation of the gate signals. The red one is connected to the collector, and the black one is connected to the emitter of the IGBT. And this circuit has been made as per the circuit diagram shown in the figure. So this is all for the UPC hard operation of this UPC as a 4-quadrant chopper, right? So in the 4-quadrant chopper, I have programmed in such a way so that the output is sometimes in the forward motoring zone, and after 2 seconds it goes into the reverse motoring zone. So this is the Arduino port that I have already shown, and then this is the hardware circuit, and this is the load. So here I have kept the bulb as well as the motor as the load. Here you see the output of the DSO, and the DC power supply has been obtained by using the rectifier. So as you see, the speed of the DC motor has increased. Right now it is at the maximum, right? Now it is falling down again. The falling down of the duty cycle can also be visually seen by the brightness of the bulb. Now there will be the reversal to the forward mode. So as you see, this is the forward mode now. So it has reached to the maximum speed. Now it is again falling down. The brightness of the bulb is also going down. Now it will reverse. Now the motor speed has reversed. The brightness of the bulb is increasing and also the speed of the motor. So this changing duty cycle is changing the speed of the motor as well as the brightness of the bulb. Both of the loads are connected in parallel. So the motor is reaching the maximum speed. So right now it is at the maximum speed. Since the output is derived from a rectifier, so the output is a bit like of a pulsating DC type. Okay, so that was all for the UPC in 4 quadrant operation mode. So in this video, I will show you the UPC in inverter mode. As this is the Arduino program which has been dumped into the microcontroller. This is the power circuit and this is the driver circuit. The auto transformer has been used to obtain a DC voltage by using a rectifier along with it, and these are the two loads, that is the fan and the bulb, right? So this is the output waveform that you can see. You can see that the time period of the waveform is around 20 milliseconds, that is 50 hertz, right? So the fan is running, but what I will do, I will change the frequency of this output and see if there is a change in the brightness of the bulb and the speed of the fan. So I'm going to 40 millisecond time period. So going to the 40 millisecond time period, the brightness is still the same, but the speed of the fan has increased. Right, so let us measure the time period also. Let us freeze it out. So as you see, this is the 40 millisecond time period based inverter, or the frequency of the inverter is 25 hertz. So the peaks are due to the sinusoidal peaks of the pulsed output of the rectifier. So as you can see, this is the positive polarity, this is the negative polarity of the inverter, and the speed of the fan has increased as the V by F ratio of the induction machine has been maintained, but the brightness of the bulb is unchanged. So this was all for the inverter mode of the universal power converter. So in this configuration, I have made an AC to DC phase controlled rectifier. So as you see, this is the program which has been fed into the microcontroller, and then the power board is receiving the firing signals from the firing board. The auto transformer is used to take the AC power supply, and the load is actually the incandescent bulb which is glowing, and this is the output waveform of the load. As you can see, that here is the delay angle. We can actually calculate, we can actually measure the delay angle by using the cursor function. So let's see. Yeah, so as you see, this is 3.5 milliseconds. So this 3.5 milliseconds can be changed into the firing angle by the equation, right? So let's now change the firing angle by changing the value of firing angle from the program. So I've updated the firing angle over here, and let's see if it is changing. Great, now we can see that the firing angle has changed, and let us again measure it using the cursor function. As you can see, it's approximately 5.50 milliseconds has been blocked. So the firing angle can be taken out by changing the time into the angle. So that was all from the AC to DC phase control rectifier mode. So I configured this UPC now in AC to AC voltage controller mode. So as you can see, that this is the Arduino program that has been dumped into the microcontroller, and this is the power board. This is the TLP board, driver board, along with its rectifier supply. And this is the load and this is the output, right? So this output, as you can see, is having 50 hertz frequency only, but as you can see it here, it is 20 millisecond. So it is a 50 hertz, but the voltage has been chopped off by the circuit operation. Now let us see the delay or the firing angle, right? So let us freeze it. Now cursor A. Okay, so you fix it up here, and cursor B. So the output, so the firing angle delay is in 4.90 millisecond in time. So we can change it into the angle, right? So let us change the angle now. So say it is something else. Say it is more than that. So I've updated the program, and as you can see, after running it, it has changed. So let us again change it to a different value. So it is getting updated. So after the updation, the new waveform is shown here, right? And as you can see, the brightness of the bulb has also increased this time. So that was all from the AC to AC voltage controller. So I have set up the UPC as a cycloconverter, right? So you see the setup here, and then this is the Arduino program that is running inside the microcontroller. We have just fed the program, and as you see here, the optocoupler boards are blinking. That means the firing signals are going, and you can see the gate signals arriving at the power IGBT mode. So then the output, you can see it here. So this is the output waveform of the cycloconverter, right? So we have decreased the frequency from 50 hertz to 25 hertz, and here is the load that is actually glowing, right? So the bulb is having a power supply of 25 hertz AC. So this is how it is working. I'd also like to thank Deep Kumar Prasad, my student, in assisting me to complete this big project.